come to an end, and as the days keep rolling in and out, there's a lot that still happens. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Scoop and Scoop. My name is Tina, and of course I am dishing what's happening in the world of celebrity. Yes, Pallaso banange yaguze moto kama mkubira mbugalo. I am so excited for this guy. Not. You took to social media and you showed us your brand new Lexus. You told us where it's from, how it has gotten here, how you are arriving. And I sat there, I was like, okay. Did Pallaso have a kambu? Yes, I know you moto kawebu na already no ya kutano. Now you got the car from abroad, so that's about like 25 million. Kubedi ogenda jibula milioni kumi, ojituse wano. So na wamu, 25 million. But I thought about it and I'm like, Pallaso, by the time you can spend 25 million, you know kukubida mubugalo. Oneka, I should clap for you and sebanange kongs. But you are making all this much wave without even a hit. Kakati wakutemi tuwa milioni abidi mutano. Ozitade kamotoka. To ina hit yo inakola bozo. Kakati buonafu na hit yo natukolote. Tokenda kwa yambule moto kojirete tujirabe. It even made me think about it. I was like, now, Pallaso, if you're taking a photo of a Lexus and putting it on social media and telling us you have arrived, what should SK Mbuga do? The guy just brought himself a California Ferrari. And I thought about it, Pallaso nebo kwato moto kabobo na mtano, no bugatta, now nawete kakono tunda, no tunda kono wechikachimu, you can't buy one car. So moral of the story is, Pallaso, when you arrive, it's a good thing for you. We Ugandans don't want to know how you get around and about. Chiswaza, omusajo mukuru. In this day and era where people have to post photos of a Phantom Rolls Royce or probably a Ferrari and you're still putting up a Lexus. It's an expensive car, but you didn't buy it brand new. So that's why I'm putting it at 25. If you had bought it brand new, zero mileage, yeah, I would clap for you, but nah. But cones, I'm happy for you. Next time, just don't tell us. Bebe Cool is back in my news again. Yay me! Bebe. A couple of months back, natula anone nkugamba, bebe kulekera ogenda mbubala bwebu mune mutabani wo! Chichina ye! So someone told me, chai kabambi bebe kuli ya kuli, dizana lekera ogenda na ye. But recently, you were at Laughters, having a blast, and guess who walks in? Alan Hendricks. Bebe kul finale yaswa deko. This is when I know this guy's listen. Mu uliriza, yaswa deko na agenda na bagamba mugambi Alan yave wada. Because it doesn't make up. It doesn't make sense. TIA, this is Africa. There's just some things that are seen the wrong way. Kwa gamba Alan nawe sikutegera. You enter the same spot. Tata wa wali. Tata wa nyo Nairobi ni gwenye mukaga. Who do you think you are? Do you ever show respect? Oli alia mtabani wa Daudi kilo tano on alia mnana. Kwa gamba. TIA, have some respect, if not for yourselves, have respect for us, the viewers, who are looking at this drama unfold. Someone is going to be like, duh, there ain't no problem me going out with my dad and kicking it. Oh, there's a problem. If half of the girls in that room have been banged around by your pups, and you are probably also planning on doing the same take around, because the girls know you're your father's son, and they all want to get a piece of something. Do you get my drift? So, I think I should not tell Bebe Cool to stop. Alan, get your own sunshine, baby. No, nyobu, kendo kuno nyobu, bala, boy, yo, it's okay. Ask daddy for pocket money. Tuchi money to zidina yon upcoming. I can't make you an artist. Gendo no nyeya kafunda kalayale kwa msaji alia life. Because nowadays he feels so small. He enters a place, he wants to take 3 beers because that's what he wants. And then Alan comes in to challenge with the whole crate. I'm just saying. Now talking about SK Mbuga, today it just hit me like an avalanche. You know people, when we have SK Mbuga angali ku his 100 game right now, you just don't know. SK Mbuga wanai yali mulimi erie masaka and not your daily average mulimi neda. Omanye guy kwa baita kalo ne wagamba wali tugenda kuzimba we nyumba tuetaga mkliaringe wo. Ya teme miti kukalo. Oh, ngalo za SK Mbuga nga ya kukubiolu yofa. Now for all of you who sat there ne mugamba, pa nae nele akayondo, ba mkubie bikonde. Waa! Guy te ya mkuba chikonde, ya mkubolu yi backhand na kone ziku wata kumtwe ne wagamba amuse. That was just a slap. Because I was wondering, why does SK Mbuga have that much? There's that thing about him, like people will talk about him but not talk about him. Ivan Semwanga tasobola kujana avuma SK. Kasajja kati niempewe katwala sayo na nayenga kakukubyoluyi. So I'm sitting there, I'm like, And Layla thought she could handle Gaya alabye ebizibu byensi. Omuti gumu n'ogutemere naku bbiri nga Layla damu kumanyira ku sente zombu ayamugona BS. Wati takuwacha oluyi n'akusuula eri. Nagamba, between you and my man, I'll take the money. Lord have mercy. But I think it's about time I started respecting SK's hustle. Because no one knows exactly what SK does. You cannot tell. Yeah, what he did wagwa. Chipenda longa agenda. But I SK. Someone needs to do. Do you think SK needs to do like an autobiography? No, a biography about his life. Okuveri masake eri munda. Lord of mercy. SK. Wevugire ka Ferrari tata. Wevugire. Simanyo ba steering. Bakutera ko ya chuma. Na evuga tata vuga. Huddah Monroe, yes, I am sipping tea and I am enjoying this show. Huddah took to social media, of course, Mnange. It's all she knows. Let me ask, do you... I've always wanted to know how educated Huddah is because pretty much I never see her text like word for word, like from me to you on the text. She always gets captions, screenshots. I'm not sure if Huddah can write properly, but I guess she can. Anyway, she took to social media as usual and she started throwing jabs at not only one person that we know, but a person who Ugandans call an expert. She took to social media, said, real women should have real life goals, not have housewife goals. I was like, shots fired, duck! Zari. She was like, you know what? You need to have your own hustle. Shout out to all my women who is not afraid to go out there and get that cake, make that money. Now, Zari, she might not have mentioned your name, but you are clearly this person who has housewife goals. Because Diamond Platinums pretty much brings the bread and cake home. You sit down, katikat kume mwaka fanani, just God forbid, in the Africa we know, if Diamond Platinums passed on, do you think Zari would have anything to her name? Because pretty much Ivan Ssemwanga had four kids with the guy. Taina Chenyamulekira. You don't have a name in Ivan. Teakuwayo Kayumba, Teakuwayo Kamotoka, nothing. Now, if Diamond Platinum's, God forbid, was to pass out and die, wachimanyo hizo kusigaza laptop erimu nyumba, akasimuke yasembo kugulirayo. Even baby Tifa will be with you for a short while because those Tanzanians will be like, give us our child. You will have nothing to your name. Now, the biggest franchise you had was the white party. When you met Diamond Platinums, you felt you had arrived, honey. You have not yet arrived. Aba Tanzania ba inzo kubako bulichimu. Ivan Ssemwanga na kugamba abana abange bakuze. What do you have? So in a way, Huddah Monroe is right. Not that it's coming from the right person because we all know Huddah has nothing going for her. She just sells her body for thought. But think about it, Zari. All in a wokachi, if both these men you have given kids to were to pass out and go, do you know you'd go back to ground zero? Oinzo kusoka no siwuka, no peruka, ateno kumano utaniko kununyaba rastarobu, ban, apati ye Kampala. Just think of a hustle, mama. Think of a hustle. But being a musoga at that, yeah, I don't think Zari hasn't nabbed enough from these guys. Duh. Hey, who decided? And yeah, my by the way story for this week that actually got me going. For the first time, I'm not going to say something bad about Maurice Kiria. You know, we're used to the old, boring, nonchalant, too coy Maurice Kiria. Well, he did something that made a lot of sense to me. It felt good to see the bad boy attitude come out of this usually very still, boring man. He gave us the middle fingers and it was all for a good cause. He was middle fingering it up for cancer and he's saying the message here is loud and clear. Go get yourselves tested on screen for cancer, breast cancer, prostate cancer. But now that we have said that, Maurice, not a bad boy in you doesn't look so bad. Now, if you put that attitude more in your songs and not just on your stage performances, I think would go a long way. The ladies are loving. Not that I'm one of them, but good stuff. Besides that, it's been my week. Catch me again. That's of course tomorrow, 10:30 in the morning, redefining breakfast television at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, or you can get me on Facebook or the Urban TV Facebook page. Scoop and Scoop, like the page. For now, I'm out. Have a blast.